Hello and welcome to another video. In this video I'm gonna be doing a bit of a different thing, voiceover with some T17 gameplay, and then I'll just hover over the items at the very end. This is pre-recorded, but basically this is how every T17 is going for me right now. I'm not personally a fan of like trying to juice T17s and getting all the like maximum loot. I'm running past even the shrines just for the sake of the video. Normally I would just pick them up because they usually add like the extra resistances and whatnot, especially when you don't have like spell suppression. And some of these maps can get a little sketchy. I've probably at this point done around 20 to 30 and I've only died once on this build in softcore SSF. So it's viable enough, at least for my experience with less than a week's gameplay. Did reach level 100 on the build. The damage feels fine for me. I've done like reduced crit and that feels really, really bad, especially when it's like reduced crit plus more life. You kind of just have like a 2-minute boss fight at that point. But you can tell we're getting 50% shocks. I have sap from the boots. I have scorch from the shield. So sometimes, occasionally, my taming that I divine for a perfect roll and then catalyst will have like more percentage damage, but it's enough with even just the chill and the shock. As you can see, no risk of dying. It's fortress, like the boss literally doesn't do damage. Just don't stand in the AoEs and don't sit on his face when he does the spin. I'm picking up the uniques because I just want to figure out if some of these uniques have different weightings for the sake of Boat League. As you can see, level 100, my strength and int and everything is fine for my build. Weapon is decent, helmet is nothing special, Dawnbreaker shield, taming, stock standard combos here for melee builds. Ashfrost Storm is the anoint because I got endurance on the chest. Recrafted a ring with a little bit better life and chaos res, and recrafted the glove so I could get like damage or attack speed on it. A shock avoid belt and onslaught boots. Standard kind of flask setup. However, I am trying out the 20% more damage with the, or more defense with the assault granite combo. Just the masteries that I've chosen and not chosen, essentially. I know there's probably going to be people that are like, well, why wouldn't you take that mastery or this mastery? It's all options. You can pick whatever the hell you want. I'm not going to like report you. The tincture stuff is like 100% mandatory in this build, in my opinion. And the, whatever the jewel is called, the Prandus pack jewel is not required for this build whatsoever. So that's it. See ya. Peace.